Hi, Jeff. I have a 2-year-old Belgian. Feels the need to bark at people no matter how many times I correct her. Any tips? Thanks.
I'm not sure how you're correcting her. So you might not be able to, you're obviously not correcting her if she keeps if she continues barking, she's not being corrected, obviously. So I don't know if you're using a bonker, a remote collar, a prong collar pop, if you're doing it when the dog is already aroused. You know, a lot of people have seen videos of me correcting, like bonking a dog that's calm, and they're like, he didn't even wait until he saw the dog get like aroused, reactive. It's like, no, the dog gets reactive every walk. I don't need to see it. I know what it looks like. A proper correction, the proper way to teach no is to put the dog into a different state of mind so it actually doesn't want to do that. So if I'm trying to rehab somebody from being an alcoholic, I'm not going to do it when they're drunk. I'm going to do it when they're not drinking and making sure they don't drink. It's common rehab. It's common rehab. Next. Hey everybody, how are you? Good evening, Saturday night. It's my name is Jeff Gellman. This is Joelle, and this is the What Would Jeff Do show. And if you've never been here before, welcome. If you're catching us for the first time live, finally you caught up to us after 15 years. So thank you so much. But what this show is, it's a Q&A show. People ask questions. Usually the questions are, how do I stop an unwanted behavior? And then most of my answers are going to be like, apply a punisher, apply a punisher, apply a punisher. Punisher, remember, is you're not yelling, you're not screaming, you're not mad, you're not upset. It's just an intolerable thing to the dog that wants to have them stop. You cannot reward the dog out of bad behavior. If you're working with somebody right now, or if you've read that you should redirect or find the dog a job or get its mind occupied on something else, it's like the only thing you need to get your dog mind occupied on is not doing it again because it'll suck if it does. So that's really the only thing that you should really do. That was weird. Did someone just pull up or beep their horn?
Somebody in the parking lot.
Somebody in the parking lot.
Setting off our boarding train.
Okay. So that was really weird. Let's close that door too after you do that. And then there's something called Jeff Gellman Seminars. Jeff Gellman Seminar. We're actually at the training center now, and it's unusual for a dog to bark. There's like 30 dogs on the property. One dog barks. We don't allow barking dogs. There's Jeff Gellman Seminars, and Jeff Gellman Seminars is a 2-day seminar series. You go to that website, and I'm sure Melissa will put it up. And that actually is around the world. We're actually going to 6 countries this year. In fact, next weekend we're in Seattle. The weekend after that we're in San Francisco, and then we're ending the year out in Providence. And the Providence one, we did special pricing because it's Christmas weekend and free gifts. So go check that out. I'm giving back to the community on that one. We're giving away some free tickets to that one. As far as if you buy like a working spot, you get an audit spot for free. It's like $400 value, which is huge. A lot of people save up for a really long time, you know, to go to these seminars. But it's in Providence, so I'm able to do stuff like that. Expenses are lower there. We were in the boarding train facility, it's more, it's all around. It's 95% of the day is obedience, and it's all reward-based. In fact, all the dogs here are trained on clicker and food. So, but to stop unwanted behavior, because we specialize in human aggression, dog aggression, intense anxiety, leash reactivity. You have to learn how to, you have to learn how to apply a punisher to your dog. And it's really, really great. And I understand why people struggle with that, especially the bonker. For some reason, the bonker, which is what this is, it's a bonker. Okay. It's a wrapped up towel. For some reason, there are people that are like, yep, I'll do anything but the bonker. And I'm like, but that's sort of like one of the best things to stop unwanted behavior. Your dog's been barking at the front window, that'll stop it. But today, tonight, I can't tell you how many emails we get a day about how successful the bonker is. And there's so many of my colleagues that are not fans of it, which is fine. But you have no problem using a remote collar, which is, you know, which is really, really interesting. So ask your questions. Most people need a longer answer than they're going to get tonight, but that's why I've got something on called AMA on Instagram stories. I've got my Patreon channel, and then also I do one-on-one Skypes. So most of it's for free. And then also I've got thousands and thousands of videos and posts. Here we go.
Gretchen says, hi guys.
Hey Gretchen, how are you?
Susan, would love to get some tips for training recall to a retired greyhound. Thank you in advance.
Okay. I'm not going to give you any tips, but there's training. So there's no tips. How do you train recall? You train the actual act of recall. So I've got a video on my YouTube channel, and that's the tip I'll give you. How's that? Because to go through the multiple layers of steps from continuous stim all the way up to correction with high levels of environmental distractions, it's very extensive. It's very extensive. So start with the video on YouTube next.
Melissa, good evening, Jeff, Joel, and everyone in the chat.
Hey, Melissa, how are you?
Bob, a custom border patrol dog growled when handler went near his food bowl. Trainer talked handler through alpha roll with handler growling and baring teeth.
Mm-hmm.
Afterward, kennel staff entered kennel. They were bit.
Yep.
Handler entered kennel, got bit.
Yep.
Comment on alpha roll and what would you have done different? Dog has nose work only, no bite work.
Well, you don't need it. Well, there's many dogs that don't have bite work but bite. All the dogs that come in here, they're called uncontrolled biters. It's not a controlled bite. It's an uncontrolled bite. So there's a big difference between uncontrolled. So I own controlled biting dogs that wouldn't bite me. Well, I shouldn't say wouldn't. I mean, I guess there's always that first time. But they've had many opportunities to, I would imagine. First of all, I wasn't there. I wasn't there. But so, and I don't comment on what other dog trainers do because people, all they do is attack me. Which brings me up a good point. So there's a really well-known person that likes to attack a lot of dog trainers. Well, guess who they attacked tonight? They went onto my son's Instagram page, and there's a video of him when he was 2 years old. So imagine 2-year-old Angelo being cute as can be, and they bullied him. Yep. How do you like them apples? So for all the people out there that are like on board hating and think it's really cool to hate, I want you to know that one of your biggest like big mouths out there went onto my son's Instagram page and bullied him. He's 7. It was a video from 5 years ago. I hope you're really proud of yourself. I hope you're really proud of yourself because you crossed a line. No idea what's going to happen to you. None. You think it's all been fun? You just wait and see now. Anyway, so I'll stop because I don't want to say anything that'll get me this channel taken off. But you don't fuck with a man's family. Ever. Ever. That's a good rule there. Don't fuck with a man's family. Hate me all you want. Don't fuck with my kids, asshole. So anyway, what I would do is we don't encourage alpha rolling. What we do is we teach the out command. And the out command is back away from the food bowl. Next.
Bob, you shared getting bit in your early days loading up a dog into the van.
Yeah.
You went to the hospital. Most would have quit. What made you decide to stay with dog training?
First of all, 100% responsibility. You know, I mean, how could I have done it differently? I mean, all I did was ask the dog to go. The dog had a flat buckle collar on. I probably would. What would have I done differently? I would have had a collar that would choke the dog out. Ironically, it's like if I talk about choking out a dog, I get hate. But it's like that would have actually kept me out of the hospital. It's hard to choke out a dog with a flat buckle collar. This dog would have slipped out of it most likely. Actually, absolutely would have slipped out of it. So, ironically, if I would have had a dominant dog collar on the dog, it would have ended within about 10 seconds. So that's what I would have done differently. But as far as how did I keep going on, I love what I do. Nothing's going to stop me, let alone a dog bite, let alone haters, let alone threats, let alone, you know, I mean, I get death threats, credible ones, like where police have to be called and stuff like that with, you know, reports filed, restraining orders. So, you know, I mean, I love what I do. I love helping people. I love helping people have a better quality of life. I'm making a big difference in the world. I know I am. I know I am because I get the emails by the thousands. Next.
Levi, hey, J&J, filmed one dog in the crate while I had the other on a walk. He barked for 6 minutes straight. Not sure what, want to get a bark collar, but will it shock him if the other barks or vice versa?
Some cheap ones do. We found some good success with...
You just knocked the light out.
Oops. Can you do me a favor and go around and plug that in somehow? I'll check this. I'll check this connection down here. Nope. You have to go. It's probably just disconnected there. Just you push it in really. See where the cord goes in? Yep. Just push it in really solid.
It is.
Okay. Uh-oh. Technical difficulties.
Uh-oh.
That's not good.
Uh-oh. Everything's falling.
Uh-oh. We're having problems here. Wow. We might have a faulty light. That's not good at all. Sorry, guys, but we can't not have light. Uh-oh. What do I do? Hold this light up here now? So, what was the question? I'm here. I'm holding this fucking outlet up.
Will a bark collar shock the other
dog? So what I would do is I would look into a Garmin bark limiter or the Ecollars Technologies ultra sensitive one, and you put it on the front of the neck and it should go by the vibration. I mean, could it? I'm sure it could, but we're historically down to like one light.
That's so weird. All right, let me just angle the other one at us better then.
Yeah. Or I'll just hold this like this and hope for the best. Like, why would that all of a sudden just be messed up?
I don't know.
Yep. Look at that one down there.
Better?
Yeah. But we'd have to turn that one off just to see. We can always turn on the overhead lights, too. Sorry, guys. Yeah. So sorry. That was random.
That was so weird.
That was so random. I wonder if something happened into this by the cords or something. Let me gently put this down and hope for the best. There we go.
Okay. Extra
Next.
Bright.
Next.
Levi said my other idea was to get a cam and collar I can use from my phone as when I'm at work. I can't use the e-collar to correct.
Yeah, I would get a bark collar. Just get a bark. We've had dogs with bark collars on in one kennel and next to other kennels. So historically, those two kind you should be okay with. Next.
Britt, what do you think about making it into an obstacle training game when on walks to make yourself the most important? I feel like it works. My German Shepherd is thriving on walks.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, absolutely. I think it's really, really great to find stuff for your dog to do. So mix it up a little bit. Do like a really slow walk, a quicker walk, a bunch of turns, sits, downs, up on objects, off of objects, go underneath objects. Sure. Next.
Levi, while on the walk filming, I tried to use e-collar at a medium level to see if it worked. Didn't seem to. I have the half mile mini, and we were just over a quarter away, but with trees and buildings in between.
Yeah.
I think that's it.
Yeah. You have to take into factor like walls and building structures, and if it's cement or steel. So yeah, next.
Britt said, I had my dad's lab over for dinner, and they were playing rough. So at the end, I had them downing and being calm today. They
nice.
Perfect.
Awesome. Proud of you. That's really, really great.
Mm-hmm.
That's a great sense that you can do that now. Next.
Dark Warrior. Hey, J&J. My brother came over for Thanksgiving and didn't tell me he was bringing his two dogs. I have a dog reactive.
That's
Roddy.
Fucking rude.
My dog did well, though. He spent most of the time in place.
Yeah, place would have been greater. Crating it down. That's just rude, though. This is the last time I'd invite them over. Next.
Bob, you did a video called Maggie Rehab Shelter Dog. You used to catch pole to take out of the kennel and load into the van. Dog was free roaming in your van. Why did she not bite you? She was a biter and had bit Steph.
I don't remember that video. A lot of times when dogs are out of their element, they don't do that. Plus, my back of my van might have also had a panel. I'm not sure what van that was. If it was the van that had the lettering on the side, it might have had a panel on it. Once a dog is out of its element, it cools down a little bit. I probably had to use a catch pole. With God, I haven't used a catch pole for years. But they couldn't get it on a leash either. Like, nobody can handle this dog. So just removing the dog from that element and putting it in the van, just getting it out of there was probably better. And I'm not sure how far the drive was. But why didn't I get bit? Most likely because there was a divider there. Most likely. Next.
Dark Warrior, thank you again for all you do. I hope you do a seminar in Phoenix soon.
Yeah, I'm trying to looking for a place in Phoenix or Tucson next. But if not, come to Vegas. Next.
Michelle Anderson, good evening, Jeff and Joel.
Hey, Michelle, how are you?
Jackie, GSD barks when people enter the house, stops barking when it's friends. My husband likes him as a guard dog. I don't like this behavior because I don't want him to scare away friends. Advice? Thank you.
Yeah, but you don't need, you most likely don't need a guard dog. You most likely don't need a guard dog. So I would just say enough, quiet, bonk, remote collar. I mean, a lot of people like they, you really don't need a guard dog historically next.
Kibu, hi Jeff. I have a question about beef liver for training. How do you prep or cook, dry it so I can use it when training?
Well, don't cook it because that destroys all the good stuff. So you can dry it. So I'm not an expert on dehydrated food, but just Google it. Just Google it. Next.
Robert, hi Jeff. I have a 2-year-old Belgian. Feels the need to bark at people no matter how many times I correct her. Any tips? Thanks.
I'm not sure how you're correcting her. So you might not be able to, you know, you're obviously not correcting her if she keeps if she continues barking, she's not being corrected, obviously. So I don't know if you're using a bonker, a remote collar, a prong collar pop, if you're doing it when the dog is already aroused. You know, a lot of people have seen videos of me correcting, like bonking a dog that's calm, and they're like, he didn't even wait until he saw the dog get like aroused, reactive. It's like, no, the dog gets reactive every walk. I don't need to see it. I know what it looks like. A proper correction, the proper way to teach no is to put the dog into a different state of mind so it actually doesn't want to do that. So if I'm trying to rehab somebody from being an alcoholic, I'm not going to do it when they're drunk. I'm going to do it when they're not drinking and making sure they don't drink. It's common rehab. It's common rehab. Next.
The doghouse. Hey guys, working with a 2-year-old dog who was raised on a harness, acts like he's dying no matter what's on his neck.
We have one right now.
Deaf improvement, but the major yelping is still happening.
Yes.
Keep working through.
Yep. We got a Shiba Inu who has never had anything around its neck at all, and it sounds like you're literally killing the dog with just the minimal amount of leash pressure.
Yeah, it just takes time.
Minimal, like we're talking like slip lead, like this. Like screams like you were killing it. So like you just put a knife through its heart. Well, maybe I just didn't win scream, but still. Next.
Armani, good evening, Jeff and Jay. Dog goes insane over golf carts driving by. Using e-collar and prong is a bit better, but still nuts and tries to bite out of frustration. Moving up on the e-collar may need to.
Moving up, yeah. How about the highest level?
May need to carry a bunker.
No, the highest level. Wait till the dog goes. The dog will get killed. Bottom line is your dog will die. It'll get hit by the golf cart and die. So, or you'll get sued. It'll bite someone and get sued. Next.
Scattered storm. Well, did you catch Jeff's sickness? You sound sick. I did.
Maybe. We traveled for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So that's what happened.
It just took a while to catch up to me.
But you know what, though? It could have also been the airplane, too.
I think it was, like, just waiting for me to get run down a little bit.
Yeah. And you were run down, yeah. Just flying, though, is too. It's like, oh, my gosh. Next.
Yeah, you coughing next to me the whole time. Armani, already read that. Terry, hi, Jeff. I saw my dog whining in the car using your method, video nonsense in car. Thanks.
Oh, you saw it or solved it? Oh, awesome. Awesome. Because I was going to tell you how to stop it. Next.
Manual garage. Hello, I got my dog an e-collar, as you suggested, to help with training my 4-month pit, but he isn't reacting to it on the max buzzer settings. He looks, then goes back to what he was doing. Suggestions?
Okay, so number one, I don't know what brand you're using, but wait, buzzer? Does it vibrate or shock? Because if it's, a lot of dogs don't care about vibrate. Also, it could be not tight enough. Second of all, you have to train the dog. You still have to train the dog. The biggest misconception, so if you're trying to just stop an unwanted behavior such as barking or jumping up on counters or getting the trash can, there's no really training involved. But doing obedience work, you still need a leash and you still need dog training skills. But it could be fit, and also I don't know what brand it is, and I don't know if you're using the shock feature, but buzzer as in vibrates, like that doesn't usually go up or down. That's usually one set thing, and a lot of dogs don't care about that. Next.
The doghouse have been conditioning with multiple different collars all day and night. Prong is the main tool being used right now. Won't eat hardly at all with leash attached. I know he's hungry though.
Yep, work him through it. It's hard. You'll become a better dog trainer after this. Next.
Michelle bullied Angelo. What the fuck? That's just the lowest of the low. They need mental help.
Nope, they don't. They need a good something. Don't worry. It's all gonna happen. All I got to say is, for all the folks out there that love to hate, karma's a bitch. It's a bitch. Do some research before you do that when you fuck with my kid. Do some research. But you'll see. Next.
Scattered Storm. Oh, shit. Hater's going to get it now. We don't even have to wait for Manchester.
Nope. But no one will hear about it, though. Don't worry. Next.
Dakota and Blessing. My coworker managed to puncture skin with a 3.0 Hermspringer prong. How is that possible? I didn't think that was possible.
I'm sure it's happened. I mean, there has to be. I mean, there are injuries. Like, the worst injury my Malinois gets injured a lot just running around. In fact, Tex has a fucking hole in the bottom of his pads from, like, just running through where we play Chuck It, you know? One of my dogs, I remember Uma, got an injury from a nylon collar. This is back when she wore nylon collars, like, with dog tags on it. She would swim, you know, they swim multiple times a day, but the collar never comes off, so it's always wet. And it was always gross, and I never really took her collar off until one day I took her collar off, and I'm like, oh my God, it's like disgusting under there.
Ew.
Yeah, but I'm sure injuries have happened, but they're so rare. They're so rare. Next.
Adam, hey guys, thanks for sharing all the knowledge with us. I have a 5-month-old Catahoula who have been working on the prong, but wondering when I can introduce the remote collar. Thank you again. 5 months old.
5 months old, you can start the remote collar now. Just do it on, layer the remote on low levels. I don't know what your skill set is, but we do a continuous pressure on, pressure off. It's called escape training. It's all done at low level, all working level. There's no corrections given at all. And it's all paired with the existing training you're doing, and you're pairing it with food historically as well. So, and it's a process. And you can go, you know, we would go 3 weeks, 4 weeks before we got to correction level, but that's working the dog every day. Next.
Nancy. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. Longtime lurker here. We'll see you at Seattle Seminar.
Awesome. Soon. Oh, yeah. Seattle's going to be fun. It's going to be a good one. Wow. It's coming right up.
Yep.
There's a good pokey
place.
I was going to say, there's a good pokey place.
So good. Bob, Jeff.
We're not staying walking distance away from it, though.
We're not?
No.
We're not? I like that hotel a lot.
I gave you two options. One with a kitchen, one without.
Oh, right.
You picked the kitchen hotel.
Oh, yeah.
So. Can't win. We got two rooms. I'll put you in the other one if you want.
The other hotel?
Yeah. Right. You can walk to Pokey.
Toodles.
Yeah.
Next. Bob, Jeff said, let there be light, and there was light. LOL.
Oh, no. Trust me. I want light all the time.
Bob, no panel, Jeff, in your van. Dog walked up to the front of the van right next to you.
Yeah. I don't know. I guess I was stupid back then.
Yeah, jeez.
I think, so Bob, God, that must be an old video because.
You didn't even back tie the thing?
I put a pen. No.
My God.
Because I used to get bit a lot, but not from dogs like that. I really felt that when the dog, when the dog got out of that environment, it was fine.
Yeah.
It was fine. Next.
Julio. Hi, Jeff. Cane Corso, 7 months old. Aggression toward people and dogs. Any advice?
Tons of advice, but nothing you're going to get in 15 seconds or 30 seconds on this. Huge, like, tons of advice. So do you own this dog or are you working with this dog? If you're working with this dog, and this is your first time working with this dog, I would rethink working with this dog because it could end your career. If you own this dog, did you just get this dog? If you did, I'd rethink owning the dog possibly. You need a certain skill set for this. Right now, cut down, there should be zero affection and start literally training every minute of the day. It's always in training. So you need to learn how to reward the dog. You need to learn how to apply a punisher to the dog. And then you need to stop the unwanted behavior and then also train what you want. So there's a lot of work you've got to do. But there's no advice I can give you like in a 30-second tidbit. You need a one-on-one Skype. All I can say is start diving into my how-to videos and do that. Get the dog muzzle trained so the dog could have a muzzle on. I guess I'm giving you some tips here. The dog muzzle trained. The dog should be sleeping in a crate. It should be crated when you're not there. You should be doing crating exercises, threshold exercises, putting an inhibition in there. Get the dog remote collar trained. I mean, it's like there's literally 500 things you need to do for rehab. Next.
Levi, do you have any videos on reading dog body language?
No, I don't because...
I feel I do a good job, especially when my GSD mix is on edge or loading and we get out of the situation.
Good. I'd correct the loading. I don't at all. There's so much information out there, but a lot of it is people look a little bit... I'm very aware of dog body language. Like, we use it, like, to read dogs. It's so... What's the word? Subjective?
Yes.
Yeah, it's so subjective, though. Next.
Bob, warning about liver treats, don't use a lot because they could reach vitamin A toxicity.
Ooh.
I think that's like a lot though. Like we're talking like pounds.
Well, yeah, we cut ours up. So we take, they come like in this big and that gets cut up into like four pieces. Mm-hmm. We don't use it like food, like because we food train next.
Colby, hi Jeff. I've been using your spatial pressure technique with my GSD in our walks. He has stopped reacting to cars. Can't thank you enough.
Awesome.
I love our time together on walks now.
Awesome. Yeah, as it should be. That's what people, I don't That's think people, awesome. I don't think what people think, congratulations. I don't think people realize that. They literally despise the walk. Mm-hmm. Like they got a dog to start enjoying the walks and they hate going on walks. Mm-hmm. There's so many people out there that hate the walk.
I know, they're just going to drag
That's you. Why it's like, we can make your walk good, sometimes in one session. Mm-hmm. By the way, we're doing a reactive dog class, a real one. January 15th and well, when I say a real one, it's like,
I know, I think it's funny you have to throw that in though.
Well, you don't need to get 30, you don't have to go to 30 classes. That's what I mean. Or 12 classes or even six. It's a two class, it's a two weeks.
Oh my God, I scared the shit out of me.
Who's calling this late? It's 2 weeks. It's 2 weeks. Next.
You changed the voicemail, huh? Dakota and Blessing, why do you sound so tired tonight, Joelle? Still pretty though.
Because Joelle,
a little under the weather.
And Joelle works. I hope people realize that Joelle works 18 hours a day. 18 hours a day she works, nonstop. In fact, tonight she probably, yeah, she will. She'll edit. She'll start working on editing a video. She can't control herself.
But I take NyQuil though.
Okay, but she is constantly working. Hardest working person I know. Next.
Thanks, that's so nice.
Mm-hmm.
The doghouse, yep, same with this dog. Use a tiny soft slip lead, and yep. He sits or flattens, yelping yep. like crazy. Thanks,
yep.
guy.
Yeah, flattening would be good for me. At least that's something. I'll take flattening.
He'll learn down.
Yeah. Next.
Paige and Kenai, is it bad to not have a regular feeding time for my dog?
No, doesn't matter. Next.
Dakota and Blessing, she managed to break skin with a prong on an American bulldog, strong but sensitive like a baby.
Yeah. And I guess, like I said, I guess it happens. I've given some hard corrections to the dog. Never happened, but I won't discount that it does happen. Next.
Dakota and Blessing, is it just me or all bully breed dogs tend to be babies and act sensitive with corrections?
Not some of the ones that I've met. Next.
Manuel, back to my question earlier. It is a pet liner e-collar. It does have vibrate and shock. I've tried shock at 70, working on obedience. He knows sit down. No, currently working on off-leash walking.
Okay, so I'm not familiar with that brand whatsoever at all. It could be fit, though. It could be fit. Also, hold it up to your hand, or they also make a test light. See if you get a consistent stim pattern. I know that the lesser known ones, the stim is not consistent. Next.
Greg, do you come to Canada? And you've helped so much. Only found you like a week ago.
Yes. Well, thank you so much for the kind words. Yes, I do. I usually do 3 dates in Canada. There is a Toronto seminar already announced, but I'm also in Buffalo. I don't know where in Canada you are, but we're shooting for a Calgary one and then possibly Vancouver. But Toronto, though, is going to hit, you know, I will not be coming to Nova Scotia, and I love Nova Scotia. The market's just not big enough, I don't think, over there for me. And people can go to Kristen anyway. Next.
Manual garage around the neighborhood. Collar is snug. I can fit 2 fingers.
Usually you shouldn't be able to fit any fingers. Next.
Bob, Jeff, video was September 2011, the Maggie video.
Okay, Bob, I believe you. Bob.
Remember the fucking video.
Bob, so it was 8 years ago. That's like...
What happened?
Okay, that's like 3,500 dogs ago.
Tell us.
I don't remember the Maggie video.
Don't watch it.
I'm not going to watch it. Obviously, something said to me, you're not going to get bit. Okay? But then again, I've been wrong before. But
that Maybe was, he did. He just didn't document it.
Okay, that was 8 years ago. But chances are, I used a catch pole because it was in a kennel going ballistic. Nobody can get near it. And it probably was not in a crate. So it was in a kennel. And it probably had the habit of biting everybody. So for some reason, it just felt okay. It felt okay. Because I used to also have crates in those sometimes. But a lot of times I didn't. All depends. Sometimes I would take them out. Sometimes I'd put them in. Eventually I had actually permanent crates installed in that van. So I don't know. Next.
Melissa posted the link to the seminars.
Oh, thanks.
Yamelia, Hello, you two. When can a puppy start using an e-collar and prong? Also, which e-collar and prong size works best from your website? I have small dogs and have never utilized them. Thanks.
I don't know how small they are, but on the e-collars, they usually tell you. So 1.75 for under 10 pounds, 10 pounds to about 45 pounds, 2.25, and then for 50 pounds and up, usually 3 millimeter. The links can come out. You can also add links to them. Also, I've got a video on how to introduce the collar, how to size the collar, how to fit the collar, and how to start working the collar next.
Laura, I have a 2-month-old Zolo and will go in the crate, but will not stay in long and will cry as soon as I close the door for over 15 minutes.
Right.
How should I correct such a young dog?
So get a bonker, say no, bonk the top. Next.
Jamie, hi guys, no training progress to report from New Jersey. Survived a head-on collision Wednesday night. Dog Jesus. Wasn't in the car with me.
Thank God.
I'm good enough to be here for your wisdom. Hope you had a good Thanksgiving.
Awesome. Yeah, that sucked. There was a collision.
Something to be grateful for on Thanksgiving.
There was a collision on the way on Atlas Avenue.
Today?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, right in front of me.
Shit.
Yeah, I know. Yep.
Scary.
Yeah, when the car was coming out the side street, another car going down Atlas Avenue. What do they call that? T-bone?
Yeah,
T-bone. Like, yep. And there was not, I don't think there was any drivers in the area. I think they both fled.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's my neighborhood.
God, how do you, like, most, usually you're really injured.
Yeah, well, in my neighborhood, they run away even when they're injured.
Oh, next. Man. Yeah. The Noble Dogs, $4.99 top chat.
Yep. Hey, Grant.
Dog is confident well with dogs in public, yep. Shut down and shakes when alone.
Yeah.
Dog is great for 20 minutes and goes into full panic mode and tries to escape.
Yeah, I know. So that happens a lot. They get their confidence sometimes from other dogs. I don't know if that's like fact or I just see that. I just observe that happening all the time. So what I would do is right now, so 20 minutes seems to be your cap. So you want to start extending that cap. Remote collar is going to greatly improve that, believe it or not. As hard as it is to do, you can actually get a dog to overcome its fear by correcting the dog for breaking a command. It goes against like, no, that's terrible. It's already afraid. It's like, I know it is, but if you're going to be afraid right next to me and don't want to flee because the dog wants to flee. Mm-hmm. Correct? He said, right. The dog wants to flee, right? Yeah. So the dog wants to flee. Next.
Laura said, I've tried hitting the crate and she keeps crying.
Okay. Shake the crate. Open up the crate and go finger poke like that. Next. This is knowing that you're giving the dog the benefit of the doubt that you've got a good bathroom schedule. So sometimes you have to go out to the bathroom. So we recommend, you know, for house proper crate training and then housebreaking, you want to have a really good, you want to write it down. Make yourself an Excel spreadsheet, actually. And, days of the week across the top, times of the day up and down, and track when you take the dog out and then what it does. So you start figuring out a rhythm, feed and water, monitor that. Don't let it just, definitely don't let it free feed and definitely don't let it free water. And then you can start getting a schedule for it next. But guess what? You got an 8-week-old puppy that's going to be whining, middle of the night pee breaks, lots of nonsense. I mean, it's a puppy. Next.
$4.99 top chat from the Noble Dogs. Tries to run back to the car, ignores all prong and e-collar information when in panic mode, even at higher levels. When it is in a good mindset, it will respond.
Yep. So hold on. Just hold on. Hold on to the leash. So take it slow. Just take it slow. Next.
Laura said it stops her for a second, then she keeps crying.
Yep. So it's an 8-week-old puppy. Next. So it's just keep that in mind. It's an 8-week-old puppy. Mm. Please understand, it's 8 weeks old. It doesn't know shit yet. You got the 8-week-old puppy. Be prepared for lots of sleepless nights right now. Be prepared for lots of frustration, but don't be frustrated because that's the worst state of mind to be in around the dog. Learn to be patient. So today, I was hanging out with this little baby and two of our clients, they were in and they had a baby and I'm like, It was their mid-training?
Yeah.
It was their mid-training. And I'm like, I'll take the kid. And kid was probably, I don't know. No, it wasn't crawling yet, I don't think. Yeah. So like less than 6 months old. And I'm like, I'll take that kid. And I get the kid. I said, if it starts crying, don't worry about it. I'll shut it up real quick. I'm really good at getting babies to stop crying. 30 seconds or less. That's like, I guess I brag about that. I got a couple of really good holds that I do with a kid that, like, you know, it doesn't mean like covering up their mouth and nose. It's like, you know, a couple of little good holds, you know, we call them papa holds that, like, get the babies really comfortable. And yeah, it was great. You put some photos up on Instagram.
Yeah, and you know Joelle has no baby experience when she... I put a story up, not even thinking. I'm like, oh, Jeff holds the baby while her owners...
Oh, the baby's owners. Well, you're probably...
Who holds this baby?
You probably were thinking the owner of the dog.
I was.
I'm sure you were thinking the owner
Instead
of the dog.
Instead of, like, her parents.
Right, her parents, right.
Her
right.
owners.
Her owners, right, right.
Owner of the baby.
Yeah. So you're... Because you're an aunt. You're a damn good aunt. So you are in baby mode sometime. But no, not baby.
It's been so long.
Yeah.
Like, they're all
But
old
you're,
now.
You, when you're here, you're definitely in dog trainer mode next.
Yeah. Dakota and Blessing. My pug rat terrier mix right now can barely keep his eyes open as he is tired, but he won't stop trying to play and won't stop barking. It's that damn terrier. How do I fix this? Do I wait till he stops?
No.
And then reward when he stops?
No.
I tell him no, it will make him sad, and saying no is abuse. Oh. She's just being a troll. Get out of here. Get out of here, troll.
She tries to get me fired up all the time, doesn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Aha.
Blessing.
Blessing, you stop that nonsense right now. Bex.
Brittany took my dog Christmas tree shopping last night. There were kids screaming, dogs, and chainsaws. He was in perfect heel, and I didn't have to correct him once. Hard work is truly paying off.
The dogs were using the chainsaws? That's some fucking damn good trick training. Were they juggling them? That'd be really impressive. So, we have a Christmas tree place. That's what we could do. Hang out over there and just get all the chainsaw noises.
Well, we have plenty of construction going on upstairs. Yeah. The dogs have got to run for their money today.
Yeah, well, that's what happens when you want to give your staff free room and board. You build more bedrooms.
It's the best distraction. We had them all out in the lobby today. Yep.
I think they finished.
Oh, man. They're going
to
be back
tomorrow. I'll have to take a look. I'll have to go up there
and
take...
We'll just have to get power tools.
And tomorrow morning, I'll take a look.
We're upgrading.
I'll take a look. No, they had to put in... we're building out another room. It's like a little two-room suite for somebody. And to be unnamed right now. So, yeah, I offer free housing for my staff. Next.
Adam.
No one wants it. Not all the staff. Some staff's like, I don't want to live up there. Next.
Adam, I used a bonker for the first time 2 weeks ago for whining in the crate. Dog was whining. I said no. Deployed the bonker, and he hasn't whined in the crate since. Powerful and effective tool. Thanks.
So, Adam, congratulations. And I hope everybody heard that. Like, that's an actual real person that got real results. Now, does a bonker always work? Sometimes it doesn't because someone did it wrong. But... man, it works for us all the time. It's like one of the best punishers out there. I mean, has it not worked sometimes? I remember once at a seminar, I was like, well, that didn't seem to help. But you never know the shrapnel effect that something might, like, help a little bit that leads to, like, success. Next.
$4.99 top chat from Michelle. She said, hi, JJ. Madly in love with you.
Excuse me. Oh, my gosh. I'm madly in love with you, too. Thank you.
Gretchen said that baby was cute. I was jealous. I wanted to hold the baby.
Yeah.
What's up with everyone wanting to hold babies?
Some of us like babies.
People Joelle. Hand me a baby. I'm like, potato. I don't.
Not me. I had that thing all bundled
I'm pretty
up.
Good with it. I held Julie's baby.
I fed it and everything. Yeah, it was great. It didn't have a little chupete though. It was like, this thing needs a chupete.
A binky.
Yeah, the thing needs a chupete. So, yeah. So I gave it its blanket. I didn't want to give it my thumb. Or my finger. Like,
that'd be fucking weird.
No, you can just give them right here. Just give them this part of your hand. Just put this part of your hand on that, and they suck on that. Yeah, but yeah. Next.
Our clients are like, Jeff, you're never holding our baby again.
Oh,
I
doubt that. Next.
The Noble Dogs, $4.99 top chat. I tried a bandana, couldn't figure out how to have it on and protect the neck. Also, what advice do you have for TikTok? Tired of all the twerking vids. Twerking vids.
So, like, what advice do I have for TikTok? So, what TikTok right now is, obviously, a lot of, like, you know, 12 to 16-year-olds dancing. Every once in a while, there's a mom on there trying to look cool. And then you get some ex or current choreographed dancers that are, like, professional dancers, male and female on there. Obviously, you can tell by their skill set. But that's what it is right now. But
is
you
that
could
people are doing dancing?
Yeah, dancing. But what you can do is you can... make the soundtrack at like 5 and just put up a 1 minute or a 30 second video. Do a training tip. Just do a training tip. Because that's what it is now, but it's going to evolve into something else. Next.
Dakota said, damn, it didn't work. Or blessings. Try to set you off.
No. Sorry. Next.
That's it right now.
That's it? Really? What's going on with the show tonight?
I don't know.
Maybe it wasn't announced.
When did you put it up?
I put it up today. Put up today. That's okay.
Paige and Kanai said, do you ever teach tricks to personal dogs or client dogs?
We have a trick trainer. Brittany does. We actually have a trick training. We have a, you could go to, guys, go to Cool Dog Tricks. Cool Dog Tricks. Make sure you get the other six tricks for a penny, but then type in GIRL, G-I-R-L, as a discount code, which will give you 25% off. So for $15, you'll get 12 tricks. Cool Dog Tricks. And if you know that famous picture of girl of Kira jumping off the tree, that trick is in there. But sit pretty, roll over, figure eight, hit it, that's called, back up against the wall, get up against the wall like you're being arrested, that's in it. What else is in there? Probably spin, some basic stuff. So do that. But we don't normally have time for that because the dogs are here to learn how to stop biting. Next.
Greg said in Ontario, excited for the Toronto seminar. Started with Prong Collar, walks are great now.
Awesome, yeah. That one's gonna sell out as far as working spots. That one's gonna be a big one. That one always does well. This one's right close to Toronto, a little bit north of Toronto, so that's gonna be a really good one.
Blessing said it was announced. What was announced?
It was announced the show. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just maybe, because people are shopping, or it's not big, or,
Saturday night.
Hey, maybe I just lost half my fan base after the female ejaculation conversation.
Maybe.
Who knows? That'll do it. That'll usually do it. Mm-hmm. That'll shut down a room real quiet.
Gretchen said, some people say they take a puppy over a baby any day. Can't relate. I'd hold an infant for ages. Babies don't have needle-sharp teeth, and they wear diapers. Also, who can resist the cheeks?
Yeah, I like the human race a lot. I like humans a lot. So I think babies are cool. There was one point when I was trying to figure out what did I want to do in my life. I thought about becoming a Manny.
I can see it.
Yeah, I really did. I really did. Yep. Did I ever tell you I took real estate courses to become a real estate agent?
No.
Yeah. Took real estate courses. Become a real estate agent. You get sponsored by a brokerage, a real estate agency. I did that. I've done so many things. But you never know. You never know. But it's always involved people, though. Mm-hmm. It's always involved helping people. Yeah.
Most industries do.
Yeah.
Think about it.
Well, they do, but a lot of people that are not just good with people. So that's what the big struggle is. They're not. People are like, oh, I'm not good with people. It's like, well, there goes 90%
literally.
Of. I guess IT is not a people job, right? And a lot of times, scientists, unless you're working on a team, is a team, researchers, data entry, a lot of that stuff is solo.
Yeah.
A lot of that stuff is solo. Next.
Hold on. I got bumped. Jacqueline said a puppy should be crated for 18 to 20 hours. What age is the crate time decreased?
As it gets older, and that's not straight. That's pretty much when you're not working the dog. When you're not working the dog. So, next.
Melissa posted the link to Cool Dog Tricks.
Next.
Bob, please compare and contrast use of prong versus slip lead versus choke chain versus martingale and any other.
Bob, are you writing a book? Come on. So, choke chain we don't use because it chokes the dog. Slip lead we would maybe use just from point A to point B. To move a dog, but that's, we don't train on slip leads. We train on, and then a martingale is a limited choke. We train on prong collars, which are different than choke chains, and we train on remote collars. But they all have different purposes, and they're all training tools. None of them work without the right training. If you don't have the training behind the tool, none of it works. It all will fail historically. It all will fail. It all depends on what your goal is. What's your goals? Next.
Sophia started 5-month-old pup on prong. She freaked out, biting and pawing at the leash and crying. Tried working through it with no success. Did I push her too hard or should I have kept going?
I don't know. Yes and yes. Yes, you pushed her too hard. Yes, you should have kept going. I don't know how long it was. We have dogs that fight like hell. We keep going, and within 30 seconds, they're fine. We have dogs that like fight like hell, and we're like, okay, we're done for today. We're done for now. We'll try again later. And then they're fine later. But I don't know your skill set. I don't know how much tension was on the leash. I don't know how firm you were. I don't know how loose you were. I don't know, like, I don't know anything about the dog. So some people say, oh, the dog's freaking out. Like, it's going ballistic. I'm like, that's not ballistic. So I'm not there. Next.
The noble dogs. How to protect the dog's neck from the prong. I tried a bandana but couldn't figure it out. Dog is a Zolo. Using the turtleneck for now.
You can take a sock. Cut the top off a sock, I guess. Right? Next.
Manual garage. Would you ever come to Houston, Texas for a seminar besides Austin or Dallas?
Yeah. If I had enough people. But this year, I guess I could. Right now, we've got 3 or 4 dates open. Texas is probably not going to be one of them because we're shooting for San Diego. Ramona is probably going to be announced. We're shooting for Arizona. And we're shooting for Calgary. That might take up my whole schedule. Next.
Paige and Kenai, awesome. Thanks. My boy has through his TKA, and we are trying to find new things to learn.
Yeah. Just, I mean, there's trick training. You can do sport. You can do agility. You can do tug. You can do bite work. You can do, like, I mean, dock diving. You can do sheep herd. I mean, there's so many different things you can do. Just damn good obedience. You can do that. You can play frisbee. I mean, it's endless what you can do with your dog, pretty much. Next.
Bob said, where is the show announced?
The show, this show right here, it's announced on through YouTube. We'll send you an email, I believe. They send you a notification. And I think that's like the biggest way to do it is you get a notification. We put up an announcement on Facebook. But I don't know if that like gives you an official announcement, like an email saying, hey, the show's about to start. Next.
God, I'm sorry I keep coughing, guys. I really can't help it. Mm. Dakota and Blessing. Babies still like to bite the heck out of people. They squirm. You can catch things from them because they are not zoonotic. I can't train them. They could be slimy and smelly. Things are dangerous. They could pull your hair and find sharp things to stab you with.
Okay, well.
That escalated quickly.
So.
They do pull your hair, though. When they get that grip on it.
All right.
You're fucked. They're just like. You're like, ow, ow, ow.
If you pinch the back of their thighs, they let go. So. Okay. So I don't know what
sorry,
kind of.
I'm never sure.
So, I don't know what kind of babies.
They try to like pry their baby fingers apart. I'm like.
I don't know. I don't know what kind of babies you're dealing with.
I agree to all of that. Well, they're slimy. They throw up on you and you burp them. Like.
That's what they make burp cloths for.
I know.
You put a burp rag on your shoulder and you burp your fucking kid.
I will never forget this one time. This was in my oldest nephew, who's 13 now. I was like just born and my sister was like doing one of these.
Well, that's
like,
stupid.
Ooh, ooh, and he threw like on
as she deserves
her
it.
Face.
As she
was her first kid.
As she deserves
and
it.
And from that day forward, I was like, I'm never holding a baby again. He threw up like
probably right after the
she
kid
like ate it.
probably right after it had a bottle or breast milk, probably too. It's like probably full on, and I bet you the kid was smiling afterwards.
Sorry, Jill, I put you on blast. This shit is so funny.
And the kid was probably smiling afterwards too. She's like, oh, that felt great.
I'm sorry, babies are gross.
No, they're not. Babies are awesome. Babies are really awesome. It's so funny watching some dads change diapers for the first time, too.
Yeah.
That's, like, really funny. And they do a crappy-ass job. It's like, hey, there are creases in there.
Yeah.
Get that shit out of the creases.
You gotta get all the creases.
You gotta get the creases, man. Mm-hmm. Next.
The noble dogs. What are the tricks for TikTok? Do they use hashtags, follows, etc.?
Okay. Go to this website, Grant. Ready? Write this down. Grab your pen. Right? Go to this website. GOOGLE.com. Go to that website and type in how to use TikTok. It'll have experts on there that have got a million times more knowledge than I do. All right? Or what you can start doing also is join it, get on it, and just start fucking around with it. That's a great thing to do. You can also go onto YouTube and type in how to use TikTok. And you'll get all these videos showing you how to do it. But since Google and YouTube are connected, all those videos will pop up in Google search anyway. Next.
Amber, my dog won't touch his food after learning out when I release him. I didn't even correct really high. I don't know what to do.
Feed in the morning once. Leave the food down for 15 minutes. Feed in the evening once. Leave down for 15 minutes. The next day, do it again. The next day, do it again. Your dog will eat. Next.
Gretchen, while I was scrolling through your feed today looking for references, I came across a video of you telling a baby at a seminar what food Sean would be eating. I'm in the mood to hold a baby now.
What food what?
Oh, at Sharon Springs where you had that baby and you're like, if Sean were here, he'd be
eating. Oh, give me the door. I was giving the baby a tour of the snack table.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gretchen, you're too young to be thinking about holding babies.
Whenever there's a baby, she's got siblings.
Yeah.
So she's probably raised lots of babies and changed lots of diapers.
Yeah,
so,
it's not fun.
Yeah, when you got lots of kids. I mean, I'm sure every one of your siblings fucking wiped your ass.
Jill, like, raised me.
Yeah, so it's really, really cool. Kids are cool. Next.
Kathy, I think it's great how much free content you put out. Been watching yours on Leash Reactivity. Thank you for all the help.
Oh, you're welcome. Yeah, my pleasure. We love it. We love it. Next.
Shadow, good evening to you both. I hope you're doing well.
Yeah, I'm doing okay. Joelle's sick. Next.
Could be worse. Michelle.
Yeah, you could not have woken up this morning.
Exactly. Here's a funny yet another person being rude about my prong. So I asked if they masturbate. Look on her face was priceless. I said, I thought it was Ask Strangers Inappropriate Questions Day and left.
That's really not an inappropriate question, though. That's actually that's a good question. That's sort of like a good survey question. Do you masturbate?
Do you masturbate?
Yeah. I mean.
Really? Are there.
I mean,
I don't want to get into it.
I mean, you made it easy for them. They could have just, it's a one word answer, yes or no.
Right. You weren't asking for full detail.
Right. It's like,
how do you prefer to masturbate?
Right. Or do you have any pictures?
Right.
Any video?
Can you demonstrate?
Right. You know, what technique, which hand do you use? Right. Which, you know,
what do you think about?
Do you watch things? You know, do you think of your ex? You know, it's like. I mean, you didn't get it.
For a crowd?
It's like, yeah. It's like, do you do it publicly? Do you do it privately? Do you do it under the sheets, above the sheets? Do you use tissues to catch? Do you got to go on the sheets?
Oh, my God.
I mean, you really could have gotten into it if you wanted to, but you didn't. So you weren't that rude. I think you were pretty polite, actually. Who was that?
Michelle,
come on, work on
Michelle
your...
Michelle Anderson, our number one YouTuber.
Michelle, work on your rudeness. Oh, you're from Canada, though. So that. Oh, you're Canadian? That was a rude question. Next.
Yeah, they were probably like, pardon?
Yes.
Pardon? Sorry, I don't discuss my masturbation with strangers. But thank you for asking.
I'm sorry. Did I offend you? Right, they probably thought you were American. You must be American being that rude. Next.
I'm going to miss Cass every day if you say something that she doesn't hear. She's like, pardon?
That's right. It's like, shut the fuck up.
She's so proper. I know. Next. Canadian girl, hey, do you make your dogs wait to eat an hour before feeding after rigorous exercise or hard play?
Do I? I'm probably a little bit conscious of that. Having German Shepherds, yes. I don't know how much validity there is to it because I imagine a dog can get bloat at any time. But I probably do. I don't know if I do it consciously or unconsciously. Next.
Jacqueline, e-collar levels fluctuate with the amount of distraction.
Yeah.
Is it okay to adjust the collar level during a training session? For instance, come
yes.
sit is one level until someone comes in and pup gets excited and the level no longer is good enough.
Right.
Increase to get the attention, then go back down to the previous level. Is that okay?
Yeah. You need to learn how to understand how the remote works, Jacqueline. Mm-hmm. So, yes. Okay. The dog controls the remote. Always remember that. The dog controls the remote. Next.
Greg said, how do I make my dog more food driven?
Greg, you know what? You want to watch some sport dog folks? Go onto YouTube, say how to increase food drive in my dog. There's some people out there that they're really good at it. They usually come from the sporting world and they're really good at it and they'll be able to help you out. Next.
Gretchen said, watching new parents try to be parents cracks me up every time. I'm probably going to be such a chill first-time mom. The Pampers ads of first kid versus second kid also crack me up.
Yeah. You'd be surprised, though, Gretch. I know you raised your brothers and sisters, but until you spit that kid out on your own, man, it's a whole nother world. It's a whole nother world. But, you know, who knows? Next.
Dakota took my sister's dog home tonight to train for a few weeks. I hope all of this won't go to waste, but I'm excited to help this little doggy for the time being.
Yeah, I mean, all depends. You should know if it's going to go to waste or not prior. If you talk to your sister about level of expectation, about follow-up, about how you're not making a robot, how dogs also have associations, and, you know, if she's going to have to change, if the dog's going to change. Next.
Michelle Anderson said, LOL, you gave me a whole list of things to add if that woman has the nerve to bash me again about my choice of training tools.
Yep, next.
Atmospherics, I love you guys and your free content.
Thank you.
That's it right now.
Okay, cool. Cool. So we head out to Seattle this weekend. After that, San Francisco. We're going to stay up there. We're going to get to San Francisco early so we can go through all the social media, make a bunch of videos. Mm-hmm. I think there was some good Wi-Fi down there. Oh shit. All right. Let's see what else. I think that's it. That's what's going on with that. Providence is going on. We just announced South Carolina this weekend.
Yeah.
This week, I mean. We're going to announce. Can't announce San Diego yet. Ramona. Can't announce that one yet. Toronto, I think we did. The reactive dog class coming up on the 15th and the 22nd. That's really, really exciting.
Of January.
Yeah, not December. Yeah, January 15th and 22nd. You can go to solidcaninetraining.com. You know, we have someone driving 5 hours to the class.
I know. That's crazy.
To a two-hour class. They're driving 5 hours.
It both weeks?
Yeah. There and back. It's like the whole day off they're taking.
Yeah.
Yeah, I doubt they're going to stay overnight. They could stay overnight. They might, yeah.
They might want to. They might want to. 8 o'clock.
I know. My gosh. My gosh. Too crazy.
Kathy said, I was a DOD boarder for a while. I can't believe that people don't train their dogs. They left here with way more manners and training.
Yeah, I know. Hey, for all the people that are buying Cool Dog Tricks, thanks. So if you missed that, go to Cool Dog Tricks. So thank you, Aaron. So Cool Dog Tricks. CoolDogTricks.com. Make sure you put in the one penny so you get the other six, and then type in girl as your discount code and you get 25% off. Excuse me. Next.
Gretchen said, well, seeing how paranoid and new other parents are, like not knowing what to do about crying before they've even left the hospital.
Well, I think it's important that people realize that up until about 8 or 9 months old, like, the child is 100% dependent on you. That's what owners have to really realize, parents have to really realize, is that, like, the baby's dependent on you for everything. They can't do anything on their own, even move. Like, so you have to be there for them. Like, you have to be there for them. So I think that's really, really important. I think it's hard. It's hard sometimes for us, we boobed every child. So, like, I was limited on what I could do. Mm-hmm. It's like, I can only quiet you down, and she didn't pump. So I can only quiet you down, like, by, that's probably why I learned so many moves. Because that's all I had. I couldn't stick a bottle in your mouth. Because it's like, it's boob or nothing, you know? So, yeah. But I think people are, you know, I don't know. I think people are more prepared for kids than they are for dogs. That's for sure.
Yeah.
I think they are.
Next. Instincts.
Yeah. Next.
Dakota said, I hate when people get mad at me for telling them they can't pet my service dog. Mm. They also get offended when I give the block command, as it puts space between me and the person, which is essential for my PTSD. What should I say?
Well, the first time to say to the other people, right? Well, the first time you can say, you know, thank you for asking if they asked, but no, you can't. And then you leave it at that. I mean, that should be enough. I mean, in today's society, thank you for asking, but no, you can't. I mean, that should be enough. If it's not, then you go right to get the fuck away from me. I mean, it's okay to have that type of contrast. So thank you for asking, but no, you can't. And then if it continues on, get the fuck away from me. Because you don't need to explain. So don't explain. The worst thing to do is explain why they can't pet your dog. Like, you can't touch my tits. You can't sit in my car. You can't take my lawnmower. You can't pet my dog. You can't come in my house and open up the fridge and make a sandwich. Like, there's no explanation needed. It's because I said you can't. Because it's mine. That's why. Like, that's enough. It's not yours. It's mine. Next.
The noble dogs. How to teach baby to not bother the dog on place. Body language, physical touch, and redirect the baby with a reward.
All depends on the age of the baby. I mean, if the baby doesn't understand the word no, then you have to pick up the baby, and the baby shouldn't be in the area that it can get to the dog. I'm really, really strict on boundaries with babies and dogs. So you don't have to reward the baby or redirect it, because you have to teach it that going by the baby is not good. But that's if the baby has a comprehension level to understand, which a lot of, depending on the age of the baby, it doesn't. So by 8 or 9 months old, Angelo knew not to go next to the dogs. So, next.
Scattered Storm said, it's quiet tonight. Go on some rants, Jeff. Talk about dysfunctional relationships or something.
I don't know, Gretchen. Do you want to talk about dysfunctional relationships, hon? So, no, I don't think. I mean, we can always cut the show to an hour because you know, Joelle's not feeling well, too. You know, we do a 90-minute show out of courtesy, but if we don't have the questions, we just be like, we're done. Mm-hmm. So, I'm not really in the ranting. I can't plan a rant.
Yeah, you can't.
I don't plan any of this show.
I got to plant the seed for that, and I'm just not doing a good job
tonight. Yeah, yeah. I don't plan any of this show.
Connected with Canine said, got my cool dog tricks last summer. Fun stuff.
Awesome, yeah. It really is fun. It really is.
Look, Eric's on the show.
I know, he just joined. I know.
He said, hey, guys, keep kicking ass.
Hey, Eric. Eric, I'll call you back when I get off the show. Okay, buddy, how you doing? How's it going?
He's like, I can't reach Jeff. Let me get on YouTube.
I know.
I'll find him there.
Jeff, can we ask you a question here?
We knew where he was.
That's right. Eric's probably sad, probably because the boat's up. The boat's in for the winter.
Yeah.
He's probably not skiing. Eric, that house that you're, the shoot house that you're working at, that you do practice at, looks really cool. That video you did with that black dog, boy, that's a terrible searcher. You don't want that dog as a partner, right? That was a cool video. That was a fun video. But that looks like a really cool shoot house. Can we go check that out next time we're out, next time we're going through Ohio? I'll let you know. I'll call you after the show, buddy. Love you.
Dakota, my sister's a little crazy. I'm hoping if I get her dog under control, then she'll like her more. Or she'll give her dog up to my other sister. I know it's not the best plan.
No, that's actually, no. Who asked that question?
Dakota.
Dakota, that's actually a really good plan. That's actually a really good plan. I mean, we have two dogs in here right now that are in for training to become better adopted. And the owner is paying for it. And the owner is going to, like, we rarely ever do this. But this is a special thing we're doing. She's got two dogs in. She has a dramatic lifestyle change. We don't pass judgment. I mean, she has a dramatic lifestyle change, and she realizes that it's in the best interest of the dogs for her not to be the owner. You know? So.
Next. Nancy said, actually, Jeff, how much do you let your dogs free roam in the house while you're home?
None. Zero. Not at all. My dogs are either outside, in my office in place, or in their kennels. I just don't find, but that's just me. That's my lifestyle. Like right now, they're lying down in front of me. Like, that's just my lifestyle. I just don't see the value of it. And I also don't want three dogs running around my house. They'll just get into shit. You know what I mean? It's just like, I'm not taking a chance. I'm not going to take a chance that they might do something stupid. Next.
Connected with Canines. Was asked if my GSC was my baby. Lady was super shocked and appalled when I said no. She's my dog. I just laughed and walked away.
Yeah, it's a weird question. Yeah, it is a dog.
Is that your baby?
Maybe she had, maybe, I don't know, maybe she had eyesight issues. Maybe she actually thought it was a baby. Is it a pug or a Boston Terrier?
It's a German Shepherd.
Oh, it's a German Shepherd. It's a BS fucking baby. I was going to say.
Oh, my God. Amy. I don't know how much longer I can go here. Throat's dry enough.
Yes.
Thank you, Jeff, for your amazing staff. Pack walks on Saturday have been so beneficial after attending the seminar in October. Just another tool to help me reinforce Bentley's training.
Awesome. Yeah, I think pack walks are over.
Yep.
Yeah, we talked about it today.
Dunzo.
Nicole wants to do them still. Nicole wants to do them.
It is cold as hell outside.
I know. Nicole wants to do them. Kristen was like on the fence. And I'm like, well, considering that I did it, it's a free pack walk and I pay you guys to do them because they're on pay, they're on the clock. And we pull them from the dogs here, that I felt that it was time to say, let's wait until the spring.
Yeah.
But in the meantime, we are possibly going to be doing a group thing, group obedience here for dogs that are trained that need distraction work. So stick around for that. So that might happen. That might happen next.
Shadow said, that must be extremely frustrating. If that's the case, I'd be much more rude. Sometimes you have to be forceful and demanding if they can't respect your
speech. Yeah, you have to be. So I'm always nice the first time, but after that, it's like I go straight to direct. And if they can't take that, that's on them.
Eric said, LOL, she's bad for sure.
Yeah.
Bob, is a shoot house the same as a kill house training for tactical? You mentioned it talking with Eric.
Yeah, so, well, Eric will better describe it, but it's for most likely SWAT training or for, it's tactical training for clearing rooms. So how to properly, I'm sure
Eric's... Wait, what was up? Was she actually bad or was she good?
She was bad on purpose. Oh. Like Eric's like, go to the left. He goes, you missed a corner. Because he goes right. Dog goes left and clears. You're supposed to clear the corner. Yeah. You know, you're supposed to hit your corners first. And and it's like she wasn't clearing her corners right. So Eric was like, "You're not clearing your corners. You're not clearing your corners." So it was just funny. Mm-hmm. It was on Instagram. It's on Instagram. But I'm pretty sure it teaches officers how to properly clear a room, how to properly stack, how to properly work together, how to not shoot each other in the head, you know what I mean? How to make sure, like, you're not crossing weapons, you know, when it's like you're in the line of fire of other weapons. And so, next. But Eric can describe it way better than I can. I don't know this shit. Next.
$5 top chat from number one Pitbull Dad. He's my favorite still. I remember, he's the one who was like, I grabbed the guy by his collar and said, what the fuck are you doing touching my dog?
That's good.
That was an epic clip. It was just me laughing for 5 minutes.
That's right. Those are always good.
J&J just wanted to send some love from the San Francisco area. By the way, I'm the one who took the guy down and tried to pet my dog. I'll see
you. I know. We don't forget.
We know who you are.
Bob, you don't have to remember that. It's not Bob. I mean, I'm sorry.
I laugh my ass off when I think about it.
I know.
It's number one Pitbull Dad.
Yep. We're gonna be in San. We're gonna be in Petaluma.
Oh my God! Please come to that seminar.
So Bob, we're actually staying in Nevada, and we're actually gonna be in Petaluma, and the seminar is in right behind the warehouse. If anybody knows what Burning Man is, Burning Man is the big huge week. Was it 5 day festival? Week long festival. One of the guys that makes all the big. I'm sure there's many of them that do the big Burning Man's movable sculptures. Like what is that? The T-Rex. Is that a T-Rex that is on wheels?
Just, like, spit on it.
Sorry.
And you wonder why I have a sickness.
Is that a T-Rex?
There are a bunch of things.
Yeah, but it's right behind that warehouse. There's a lot of chickens there. A lot of chicken warehouses there. All chicken warehouses. Next.
Chickens?
Yeah.
I don't know where I am. Scattered Storm. I don't have a problem saying no to letting strangers and family members who don't live at home pet my dog. But telling them it's simply because of boundaries or that he's training seems to not be valid enough for them. My brother, who visits from college especially, will hand him a burrito if I'm not looking and deliberately slice him as much as he can to try to annoy me while he's on place. Oh my God, my brothers are the same way. It's why I just don't talk to them.
I'm just kidding. No, you're not. Your ex-husband was
That's
the worst,
so
though.
So annoying.
He was like, the worst.
I can't. Just cut them off.
Right.
Do you have any advice?
No, for Gretchen? Yeah. Just don't go out of town when your brother's in town next.
Hand him a burrito. He can clean up the diarrhea.
There's probably stuff in the burrito that's actually poisonous to the dog.
Next. Probably. Paige and Kanai, 4-month old dog is already humping all the big dogs. Advice, none of the dogs it's with correct the behavior.
So I would use a bonker, no, bonk the dog. I would use a stockyard whip, no, spanking on the ass, next.
Dakota and Blessing, service dogs need a little bit more than basic obedience, but not quite competition obedience. Do you think that trick training will help? We do stuff like between, which is between my legs for space.
That's up to you. I don't do service dog training. I just do public access. So next. It couldn't hurt. Next.
Connecting with canines and no free roamers here either.
Yeah.
Eric said, correct.
Correct. Oh, that's what the stack house, that stack, the kill house is, the shoot house. Next.
Connected with canines. Haha, she was a cat person.
Yeah.
Dakota and Blessing, number one pit bull dad. Do you have that on video? Oh, of him throwing the guy down?
We made a clip out of it, right?
Yeah, but I want to see him actually taking somebody
down. Oh, does he have it on video? Does he walk around with a GoPro?
Hey, Jeff told me.
That's right.
To take you out. Next. Francis. Going to buy tickets to your Frederick, Maryland seminar as soon as the show is over. 2 working spots.
Awesome. Yeah. Frederick is going to sell. Frederick always sells out. That's a
That's a good one.
That's a very well attended seminar. Yeah.
Number one pitbull dad said, my name is Chris. My dog has no issues, but I may come anyway.
Just get an audit just spot. Come. Chris, just get an audit spot. Leave your dog at home. Next.
Shadow said, I feel like I need that video in my life. LOL.
Yes.
It's a good one. Just look in the archives.
Look in the archives, yeah.
Connecting with canines. I think I titled it like, when the what would Jeff do movement gets taken too far or something like
really?
That.
Really? Yeah.
We do a year-round pack walk in Oregon, rain or shine. I charge $5 a team. Had 20 dogs this morning.
Good for you. Yeah, we do it for free. And it's our second year doing it, I think. And we do not do it year-round. And it was like 30 degrees today, and which isn't that cold. It's not like there's tons of snow. There's no
freezing.
Snow.
We're getting snow but tomorrow.
At some point, we just stop. Yeah, next.
Emily, coming to Phoenix anytime soon?
Oh, excuse me. My gosh, between the lights and the yawning and the coughing. My God, we're running a fucking good show tonight.
I'm so sorry for everyone on the replay. They're going to be like, what the fuck?
How about the replay? How about the live?
Yeah, but at least they can see that, like, I'm physically sick. The replay, you're just listening. It's like, oh.
Do you mean on the podcast?
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah, podcast. Yeah. What was the question?
I don't know. Okay. Are you coming to Phoenix?
I'm trying to. I need to find a location in Phoenix or Tucson next.
Janine, hey guys, me again. Love you. My AB has been in a few fights. Can I get a second dog?
I probably wouldn't until you figure out that fighting thing. And I don't know your skill set, but if you own a dog that's dog aggressive, I would highly rethink the concept of getting another dog. Next.
Poor Gretchen. I feel her pain. Dakota and Blessing, where can I find pack walks in Florida? Do I just Google it? Does Tori do one?
Tori does one. In Winter Springs, Winter Park, Winter Gardens, Winter Springs. Yep.
Gina, hey guys, took Max to PetSmart for Black Friday. He did great. He did whine in his sit stay but didn't budge. Should I correct this?
I would, yeah. Low-level remote collar. Next.
Gretchen, you tell him that, Jeff. He's like, it's just onion and salt. Chill out. If I told him the beans are going to give him the farts, he'd add extra beans. I'm stuck here. I can't go anywhere until I move out next fall at earliest. Yeah.
Gretchen.
I fucking know that struggle, man.
Hey, Gretchen.
Brothers are the worst.
Gretchen, you're the one that wanted to be a 17-year-old teenager. Like, right? You picked it. Next. You should have gone right from 16 to 18. Next.
Shadow, so as someone who's training my own service dog, trick training is a great way to build confidence and obedience to commands.
There you go. You heard it from the words of someone that does it. Next.
Sandy, does marking by 9 months old GSD need to be corrected or stopped? He pees everywhere. The other male he doesn't get along with urinates. Is there a reason he's doing it?
I mean, dogs mark. I mean, it's very common. You know, is it normal dog behavior? Probably. I just don't like it, so I would stop it. Next.
Dakota and Blessing. Who is Tori? Do you have
her info? Yeah, sure. She goes underneath. It's Tori Smith, but she might be underneath Victoria Smith. Take the lead canine training. Take That's the lead canine training. Yeah. So, and she was underneath Victoria Smith, though, but her name is Tori. I don't know why she's so formal like that.
Her name's actually Victoria, and her nickname is Tori.
Yeah, well.
Her name's Tori, not Victoria.
I can't imagine calling her Victoria or Vicky.
Vicky. Hey, Vicky.
I mean, usually Vicky's are Victoria. Vicky's are Victoria for short, right? I'm just trying to think. It's like, am I wording it backwards?
Or Tori. You can do Tori, too.
Yeah, okay. Well, there you go.
Kaylee J. Hey, J&J. Just got back from Thanksgiving with 5 out-of-control 60-plus pound dogs. Glad to be back at my quiet, calm house.
Yeah, I know. I know. I don't think people realize that, like, you can have a better quality of life. It's like, so many people send us photos and they tag us on Instagram of, like, 3, 4, 5 dogs all lying down while they're, like, eating a meal or watching TV.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like, it doesn't have to be like this, guys.
Right.
Like, it doesn't have to be like this. Next.
Gretchen said, easy fix. I'll just identify as 18. Funny how teenagehood is the year of, I can't wait till next year, every single year.
Yeah, but you know what, though? These are important years. Gretchen, you know, what you're learning now in life, the good and the bad is important. The good and the bad is important. It's all part of growing up. Next.
Janine, sorry, guys. I did not hear the answer to my question. Do you mind repeating?
I don't know what your question was.
I haven't seen it at all.
Yeah.
Just ask it again.
Ask it again. You might not have. For some reason, some people are like, you skipped me. I'm like, no, your question never came through.
It might have been too long.
It might have been too long of a question. You might not have hit send, but, you know, I don't remember seeing a Janine pop up. Janine pop up either. That's weird how sometimes it does it. Sometimes it just gets lost. Mm-hmm. It's like uploading a Facebook video sometimes. And then all of a sudden, like,
shit gets lost in cyberspace.
But then all of a sudden, like, four of the same posts come up.
Yeah, because I've tried uploading it 100 times. I'm like, gnashing buttons.
Actually, I had to upload one for you this week.
Like the other day, somebody's like, can you post this to Facebook? I'm like, I'm trying. I've been trying all fucking morning.
I know. And then there was...
And then I had to send it to you to upload.
And I couldn't upload it from my phone, so I uploaded for... I got it from my...
Facebook, fix your shit.
I got it from my laptop. Next.
Kaylee J., there's also a dog fight because a couple dogs were resource guarding a family member from each other, but they are dogs. I'll be training to get some experience.
Oh, this is from the dinner, the Thanksgiving dinner?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they need to box those dogs up separately. Like, that's just dangerous. It doesn't have to be like that. It's enough to be like that.
Oh, Janine was the one who said her dog has been in a few fights. Can I get a second dog?
Oh, I answered your question at length, actually. I said it's probably not a good idea until you straighten out, like, your dog. But I don't know what it led. I don't know, like, your dog's personality. I don't know your skill set. I don't know, like, what the other dog is that you'll get. There's so many variables. Next.
Interdine International Canine. Hey, J&J, happy Thanksgiving.
Oh, happy Thanksgiving
to
you.
Hope you all had a nice holiday. Jeff, what are your thoughts on the Chameleon 3 collar?
I don't know, because I've never used it. So I can't give you a... I don't know. Looks pretty cool, but that's... I don't know. So, next.
He also said in something called the Bull Fang from High Tech Pet. Any thoughts?
Again, I don't know these collars. I don't know these collars. So I only know, like, basic Hermspringer prong collars. And then I have experience with Dogtra and Ecollar Technology Remote. And in my seminars, some people have Garmins with the blue, which I don't like the Garmin box that it is. And then Sport Dog. I prefer Ecollar Technologies or Dogtra. So I don't have experience with those. So I really can't... I can't give you an opinion, and I would have to have used it a lot. So all of my answers are based on hundreds, if not thousands, of events, of experiences. So it wouldn't be fair. Yeah, yeah. So what I would do is, I think a lot of the sport dogs, working dog people use those. So what I would do is I would refer to them. Next.
Kathy, is AB American Bulldog?
Usually, yeah. Or it's AB testing when you're talking about, like, social media.
Hold on, dog training. Good evening. I'll catch the replay. good stuff this week from you guys. Hope your holiday weekend was awesome.
Thanks. Yeah, we put out a lot of good stuff. Yeah.
Janine said, when will you be in Toronto?
Go to Jeff. I don't even know. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. And it's in there. It's in there. So, yeah, I don't even know when it is. It's in 2020. That's when it is. Because the only ones that are left this year, we've got Seattle, San Francisco, well, Petaluma, but San Francisco. And then, and you know what I was thinking about the San Francisco seminar? It's like, I'm going to look, like, when we get off the plane, I'm going to see if there's a different way to get to, like, where we're going. Because we drove, like, through, like, city before we got to the highway. I'm really surprised from the airport, there has to be a highway system that gets to where we want to go. Maybe not, though.
It wasn't last time.
I don't know. It's really weird. It's really, really weird. Did we go over a bridge?
Yeah, we went over the Golden Gate.
Did we go over it?
Mm-hmm. Interdyne International said, thanks. They all look great in the marketing materials.
Yeah, of course they do. So does fucking dog food. Dog food packaging looks really good, too. Next.
He said, thanks so much. Have a great holiday.
Yeah, you're welcome. Sorry I couldn't be more helpful. Yeah.
Connected with canines. Purchased my audit spot for Portland. See you in March.
Oh, awesome. Good. It'll be fun.
Greg, my dog has lots of dog friends, but is nervous to new dogs. What should I do?
You know, your dog doesn't need a lot of friends. Like, just the fact that your dog has one or two, that's huge. Next.
Nancy, oh my God, I'm going to try the no free roam policy. I only ever used the place command for when there was a lot of distraction. I didn't think to use it for when we were relaxing, too.
Yeah, just try it. I mean, it's a lifestyle. I just don't see the value. I'm like, again, this is my lifestyle. I just don't see the value of dogs walking around a house. That's all. Next.
Jared, dog walks great for 45 minutes, but starts whining when we get through the front door. We tried remote collar correction, low and high. It doesn't stop the behavior. Ideas?
Wait, are they home already?
Sounds like it.
Bonk the dog. No bonk. Next.
Gretchen said, I also noticed you guys changed the podcast title. And of course, typos first time, LOL.
Well, I do all the titling. And did I change the title?
We changed the title?
What's the title? I might have said, and not just dog training, I said maybe more stuff or something. Of course there's typos, because I did it. That's my trademark. Next. I do typos on purpose. You know what I do? There's like, I remember, I do typos on purpose just to see who, just to, especially on YouTube titles, because people like to point those out to me. Mm-hmm. They're like, that was like the most helpful content ever, and your comment is the typo. Mm-hmm. It's like, that's a tell. That's such a tell from somebody that like can't oversee the typo. So, not you, Gretch. Next.
Dakota and Blessing, how do I get my dog to stop being so dramatic for corrections? I just have to look at him, and if there's another dog, he'll start screaming, and all eyes are on me.
I have no idea. Correct more. Get your dog used to it more. There are some really sensitive dogs out there. There's dramatic dogs. There's dogs out there that are like, that information didn't warrant. It's the same thing with rewards. Like, you give a dog a tiny pet on the head, and it goes ballistic with excitement. It's like, whoa, my gosh. Next.
$4.99 top chat from the Noble Dogs. Dog excessively pants and drools in the crate, working on putting the dog in and out of the crate multiple times, down in crate, only letting dog out of.
Yeah, put the dog into a double down, like head down, all the way down. Next.
Number one Pitbull Dad said there's no other way from SFO. Just take the one-on-one.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, it was really weird. We went through a bunch of neighborhoods. It took us like 20 minutes before we actually hit highway.
Yeah.
Probably longer than that. Is that when we went to that Middle Eastern restaurant, though? Was that San Francisco or was that Vancouver? I think it was Vancouver.
I don't know.
Remember that one place we went to? Yeah.
I don't know where we were, though.
Yeah.
Interdyne International said, cheers, you guys. You're always helpful. Keep up the good work.
Oh, thanks. Thanks. Have a good holiday rest of the year. Next.
Janine said, if you shouldn't introduce face-to-face, how should you?
There's too many variables to introducing dogs. Face-to-face, definitely not, because that's where their faces are, and that's where their teeth are, and that's where they bite from. Migrating is usually good. Go for a walk. But there's a lot of variables. I don't know your skill set. Next.
Jared said, when we get home, yes. Bonkers don't stop the whining at almost any time. We overused it. Working our way back from that. Leash correction with Prong makes the whining worse.
Okay, so remote collar might do it. Also, what I would do is at the bottom of the driveway or the drive, do lots of obedience, go towards the door, away from the door, towards the door, away from the door, sit down, boom, 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 but a lot of fast-paced stuff. Go really, really slow, work your dog really, really slow. More people buying cool dog tricks. Thanks, guys.
Another $4.99 from Grant. He said letting the dog out on permission basis as well as e-collar with baby cam all away. Anything I am missing?
Let's see. On permission basis, let the dog out as well as e-collar with baby. If it's drooling. Drooling can be hard. Having the dogs, okay, panting. Panting we can stop through low level on the remote collar and putting the head down. That we could do it. But also, Grant, I would say, what's the rest of the day look like? Meaning, are you creating calmness out of the crate as well? So doing duration work. So some people be like, exercise the dog more. It's like, I wish that was the answer for a lot of behavioral problems, but it's not. Next.
Melissa, does Herm Spanger have hypoallergenic prongs? If not, which ones would you recommend?
Corrigan? Am I going to pronounce it wrong? Corrigan or Corrigan? I don't know if Herm Spanger makes it, but yes, they make a hypoallergenic prong. Next.
Kara, should I correct tail wagging when dog is in place and someone walks in or walks up to her?
Pick your battles. What happens after that? Next.
Kara said, my dog bumps my hand with her nose while in a heel. I've been correcting, assuming it's her being pushy. Does this sound right?
Say that one more time.
Dog bumps her hand with its nose while in heel. Is it being pushy?
It might just... Your hand just might be right in that one spot. I mean, it could be. I don't know. I'd have to see a video of it. But don't send me a video because I don't watch people's videos because I don't open up files because it might be a bug, you know? So, I don't know. I mean, it could be pushy. It could be just, like, looking for comfort. Next.
Gretchen said, who the heck has money to buy Jeff's cool dog tricks when Black Friday was literally yesterday?
Yeah, I know. Who's got 15 bucks? Like, geez. I know. That's a lot of money. Next.
Kara, when walking two dogs at once, should they be on the same side, or is it better for them to be on separate sides? One dog usually goes back and forth if I try them both on the same side.
That often happens. So personally, I say, what's the most comfortable for you? So what's the most comfortable for you? So I prefer dogs on the same side, so I have a free hand. But there's always going to be one dog. So what you do is keep one leash a little bit looser and one snugger. When you pop, the dog that forges ahead gets the pop, and the one that was looser does not. Or you can reach your hand over and pop the offender's leash. Excuse me. Next.
Janine, dog started humping and jumping on me while holding my friend's newborn baby. Ooh, what is the best way to correct?
Kick the dog. Seriously. Let that dog, if you didn't have a remote collar, which I wouldn't do holding a baby, I would, if dog ever jumped on me while I was holding a kid, that dog would fall flat on its ass. Oh my God, that's so terrible. Really? My God, you're holding a baby. No, it's not terrible. It's called smart fucking dog ownership. That's the problem today. That's the problem today, that people look at something like that and think it would be bad. Mm-hmm. Like, you're holding a live human being and your dog jumps up on you. Oh, it doesn't know any better. Exactly. And it's going to learn right now that was a bad idea. Mm-hmm. These are simple. They're really simple concepts. Jumping on me at all is a bad idea. Jumping on me with a baby in my hands is a really bad choice to make. But so many people are so sensitive to that it's like, oh, it's going to hate the baby. It's like, no, it's not. It's going to hate jumping on you. Like, that's the goal. Do I tell people to, like, kick their dogs off of them? No. Like context. That's the biggest thing is people just don't have context to my comments. Mm-hmm. They just don't. There's still people out there that are like, he doesn't even train obedience. It's like, have you not been to, like, don't you see what we do? I don't talk about it on the show. My seminars, we don't do a lot of obedience, even though we show it, because people are looking at stop stuff. Mm-hmm. My dog is trying to kill another dog. Oh, teach it how to do a downstay. No. It's like, no, stop this from happening. Stop this from happening.
Yeah.
There's like, my dog is leash reactive. This is the best one. The dog is leash reactive. Why don't you teach it heel? It's like, it knows heel. Mm-hmm. It does heel very well. It can actually heel frontwards, backwards. I can call the dog to a heel from the front, from the side, from the back. But when it sees an environmental, it goes ballistic. That's called leash reactivity. I'm always amazed by people that don't understand that concept. It's like, it already knows heel. That's why you correct it for leash reactivity. But for somebody to say, just teach it heel, it's like, no shit, Sherlock. It fucking knows heel. Like, I see these comments all the time from these haters, and I'm like amazed. It's like, do you actually work with dogs? Do you actually know what you're talking about? Mm-hmm. It's like, of course you teach it heel. I'm not correcting it for not knowing heel. I'm correcting it for exploding. And yes, that's what you're supposed to do. Then what does the dog do? It goes back to the proper heel, which you've trained it to do. That's always so funny. That's one of the more funnier comments, because it's so like, do you not think we actually teach dogs how to heel? Mm-hmm. It's just so interesting. It really is.
Yeah.
You're having a rough time. Let's stop the show.
I mean, it's 9:30 anyway.
All right. All right, guys. We're going to say goodnight. And Joel's having a rough time. What day of the week is today? Saturday. So, yeah, Sunday to recover. We'll be here Monday. Looks like Cass is doing Monday's show.
She might need to.
Cass is doing Monday's show. If you're going to be like this, she probably should.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably be able to use any of these clips.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you will.
Coughing the whole time.
I think we should just do a coughing clip.
Cool.
Just do one of just cough. Are you supposed to do one of me of just like, we should just do one of you laughing. Just do a laugh track. Who wants to see a 1 minute laugh track of just Joelle? A 5 minute laugh track, the best laughs of Joelle. That wouldn't be that hard to put together. We can just grab a bunch.
I'm gonna blow my nose.
Okay. All right, guys. Madly in love with you. JeffGellmanSeminars.com. SolidCanineTraining.com. Madly in love with you. Don't forget, we've got that reactive dog class coming up. And then also, we'd love to see you at a seminar. All right? Take care, everybody.
Good night.
Wonderful. Have a good weekend. See you at Walmart tonight at 2 a.m.